Antwerp in this area is a cutie, a great cutie. You can move in there. And the smallest being a steenbok. Smallest antler up in this area. We do often see the steenboks around, especially in the high ground and open areas. And that's where they are frequently found and seen. You could also find them in this kind of a habitat. In a very dense habitat along the dry river beds, the drainage lines. This is the leopard's country here. The ideal habitat. For the leopards. That's what I'm checking here. You never know what could be lying down in the riverbed or in the trees. Yeah, there's a perfect trees for the leopard to rest during the day and hosting the kills. Thanks. There's a beautiful large converted trees. There's a variety of large tree species here just along the riverbed. Large marilla trees, the jackal berries, the leadwoods trees. So the trees and the vegetation that grow up alongside the riverbeds are extremely, extremely large. Yeah. Tend to be bigger. And the trees and the vegetation. vegetation that grow on the high grounds. And there's one reason for that, why they tend to get extremely large than the other trees growing away from the riverbed. And the reason is, or the difference is, water table. So the water table is down in the low-lying areas, and then the riverbeds and drainage line is higher than the high ground. So the high ground where the table was very, very low, yeah? And again, the different type of soil. So the soil down there in the low-lying areas, so the drainage lines and the riverbeds, it's very, very rich. So the grass and that grows along those areas, it's highly nutritious, it's palatable, and we find a variety of antelope species and hanging around in those areas. Very good quality of food. Jack, afternoon to you. And Jack wants to know the bees that were around the crocodile. What were they? There were two different types of bees that were around the croc, the jacana and the water dacop or thick knee. Dacop is the African's word, meaning thick head. Dacop. Big head. Now they call them a thick knees. But thick knees. From a thick head to thick knees. But certainly they do have their thicker knees, so it's a perfect name for them. I still prefer the dacop. Dacop. I'm still sticking to my old bird's names. driving to the sun now. Just rechecking the water hose. I don't know. You never know what could have popped out behind you. Yeah? And this is about time for the animals to start getting active, getting down to the water holes and drink before dark, and then go look for a place to take it easy for a night. Very good. Afternoon to you. And Peggy. Is asking about the parts on the crocodile's jaw, and if you can be able to tell whether there's a male or female. I honestly don't know, Peggy, if you can be able to determine the sex of a crocodile by looking at the jaws, or the parts on the jaws. It's obviously a one way to tell. Is to look at the size, obviously. Now trucks tend to be larger than females. The larger. Tails are thicker. And longer than the females. Allen. Good afternoon to you. And another couple of questions. Alan wants to know the difference between the alligator and the crocodile. And he said, is the alligators take the predator under the water, drown it, and swallow it. Does it same apply to the crocodiles? Very much so, Ellen. Very, very much so. So the crocs also do the same. I was right when I said I had a hippo snatching a tree dam. Sorry, that tree house dam earlier. I'm just going to look at him briefly and carry on. But they do the same, and the crocodiles also attack the prey under the water. Drown it and swallow it, because they also can't chew. There was an interesting theory about the crocodile, how they feed. People actually, my grandfather told me the story, and he said because the crocodile can't chew its food, and then when it drowns something under the water, and it will take it into the running water. I don't know how possible that was. Take it into the running water, and it must face in the direction where the water is coming from. Hope I'm not confusing myself. And it will position the meat in the direction where the water it's coming from, and it will open the mouth widely, and the meat will come running with the water, and then get into the croc's mouth and swallow it. Thanks, Tara. And Tara is also saying that she has also seen the footage of of that feeding behavior with the fish as well. So maybe it's true that the crocodiles do that. That's, they will take the food into the running water, position the meat in the direction where the water's coming from, stay there and up in the mouth and in the water, and then the meat just get into the mouth and just swallow it straight away like that. But my question is, they only do that in the running water, but the dams like this where the water is absolutely still, they just swallow it straight away. Maybe they just what is the word? Sort of lift the whole body, or positions the body upright like that, and then swallow it, and then go down again, tear off another piece, and then do the same thing. And the crocodile's teeth are not exposed, as you will see on alligators. They keep them inside the mouth, the crocodiles. This is a humdinger, by the way. He was obviously hiding under the water when we were here earlier this afternoon. The hippo can stay under the water for about 5 to 7 minutes. And we only stopped here for about a couple of minutes or so, and we moved on. They're starting to show off now. It's very typical with the hippo balls in the late afternoon, just before the sun sets, to start showing off. Opening their mouths, spinning around in the water. It's about time. Not about time. It's nearly time for him to go out and graze. So we're going to be losing the light in the next an hour or so. And the temperature is gradually dropping. So in the next half an hour's time or so, it will be nice and cool. So the hippo is just exercising to go out and graze. There we go. That's the sound of the head earlier. The
Okay. Shall we move on? Let us hit the road. Awesome, man. Absolutely stunning. Just switch off another minute or so and he might do it again. Now it's going under the water this time. Now he's up again. It's a very special thing to see the hippo doing the threat display. It's opening the mouth widely like that. It's checking us out. It's coming towards us. He's in the shallow water now and you can see his back sticking out on the surface. It's lying down. So if he stands up and then you can see the whole body out of the water. So he's walking on his knees, Ed. When a hippo is under the water, it doesn't look as big as it looks out of the water. It was action before we go. He's not interested this time. I think we should leave him to himself and in peace, not in pieces. Bye, Mr. Heaper. Have a wonderful night. And we'll see you in the morning. Look at that. As we're leaving, and then he's showing off. He was just had to play again. Silly hippo. Susan, good afternoon to you, and that's a clever question. Susan wants to know if the crocodile at Gali Dam is the same crocodile that was at Queen Dams about a couple of weeks ago. Possibly, yeah. Very possible, Sue. Very, very possible. So it could be the same guy, eh? That was at Queen Dams, as I said, yeah. Same crocodile, because the crocodile that was at Queen Dams is no longer there. So he disappeared all of a sudden, and suddenly there was a crocodile at Gali Dam. So I have a very, very strong feeling that it could be the same crocodile that was at Queen Dams. I could have traveled overnight. To Gali Dam. If you look at the size of Queen Dams compared to Gali Dam, it's maybe small, and Gali Dam is about 4 or 5 times bigger than Queen Dam. And so we could have run out of food. At Queen Dams and and we moved to Diary Dam. It's the largest dam where it might. Sufficient food availability. And that's one of the reasons why we don't have the caravans staying permanently in our dens. It's about food, lack of food. That's why the crocodile that was at the Babsuk Dam did not stay there for long enough. As we anticipated him to stay a bit longer. So he stayed later than expected. No one really knows how long he's going to stay at Gary Dam, so he might stay until the end of the rainy season, or we can decide to leave tonight. It's just really hard to guess. So let's just ahead. Keep our fingers crossed that he sticks around for longer. Nancy is also wanting to know if the dam cam was pointing to where the croc was. Of course it was. Pointing at where the crocodile was. It is just that too far for the camera, and then it's an HD camera, and then it zooms manually, not automatically. So we're sitting in power control and we can zoom it in and out. So we can turn it to the sides. So if something is on the far side of the dam, and you can't really see much. You can see the movement, but not very clear sometimes, especially when it's overcast and raining and dark. Asking about the giraffes, how do they sleep? Do they sleep standing up or do they lie down? Certainly they do lie down and they fold the legs under the biscuit and they keep their head in the air. But sometimes I've seen a giraffe lying down or sleeping with the neck hanging over like this. Especially for the youngsters and the babies, they are able to manipulate their necks. But generally, the adults they just lie down and then they keep their head in the air. The necks are too long, man. Again, the giraffes have a high blood pressure problem. And the giraffe lies down on the other animals do, like the rhinos will lie down on the sides of the stomach. And lay the head flat on the ground. Can't get up. Can hardly get up. And if it does lie down in the position up there, and it may die of high blood pressure.
And again, in terms of safety, it is very dangerous for them to lie down in the necks or flat, or the whole body flat like that. This is for the giraffe to get out of it, and it's quite an effort. Even if you see the giraffe drinking water at the dams, and it's quite an effort for them to bend over in order to reach the water. So, in order for them to reach the water, and the spread the legs, the front legs, wide open like that, and then unlock the back legs and drink like that. Some giraffes will bend the front legs forward, sort of a V shape, to be able to reach the water. Gorgeous sunset. This afternoon. So when the giraffe is drinking water, and then all the blood, and then it's running into the neck and up into the head. Can you see the sunset? Try and buy this over there. The wallabies, babies. Planning.
the matter. Where was I? Taken by the giraffes, drinking water, and the high blood pressure problem. And in the next. They have a whole lot of valves that help to slow down the blood flow into the brain when they are bending over and drinking water. And if you see the giraffe finishing drinking water and immediately it stands up and it will shake its head just to get the blood flowing back into the system again. Just going to remain silent and enjoy the stunning sunset. Wow. Where else in the world? Have been part of all of this. Don't run away. That would be nice. To say goodbye and with the whole head of Impala and the Vibras standing behind me. So where else in the world? Can you see a stunning sunset like that? Absolutely stunning sunset. And a beautiful ending of the PM Safari with the whole herd of Impala and the Vibras in the background. And thanks very much for joining Wildlife Safari. And all the questions that are sending them through, it's a very big thank you to the other again. And having a wonderful camera work, Tara, thanks for the lighting. This afternoon, and you've been watching World of Safari. My name is Patrick, and we'll see you in the morning again. Bye for now.